talks about women who have daddy issues. But what about guys who have mommy issues? They do. We do. We guys have mommy issues. Okay? Just as women, certain women, of course, have daddy issues, usually the dad was sort of like indifferent to the girl, and she grew up sort of like chasing the affection of the father, and therefore, as an adult, she winds up chasing men who are really inappropriate for her, right? Guys do the same thing. Guys have gone through the same experience. Guys whose mother was perhaps not indifferent to them, but not sufficiently comforting to them, or there was a sense of insecurity, they grow up and they wind up having mommy issues. But see, it's not that they want like big boobs or something like that. No, no, no. It expresses itself in a very weird way that I have seen countless times, and in my own case, in fact, I've noticed that I do this. They chase indifferent women. Yeah, in my own case, I'll tell you right now. The girls who were crazy about me, I kind of blew them off. Yeah, I was just not interested. I was like, oh yeah, I can have her whenever I want to, so screw her, you know? I mean, at first, when it was like, oh, I'm not sure if I can get her, yeah, I chased her. But once I realized that, you know, it was a lock, yeah, I kind of like blew them off. And I'd blow them off and go chasing after girls who were completely indifferent to me, yeah? Sometimes those girls were way out of my league, sometimes they were below my league, but just simply just didn't respond to me for whatever reason. I'd chase them. It was crazy. It is crazy, because it still happens to me. Oh yeah. Weirdly, this thing of chasing women who are completely indifferent to me, especially women who are of higher status than me. I mean, we all know that there are girls who are just, you know, out of your league, right? I would chase girls out of my league, especially when I was in New York, living in New York City, where all the women were basically out of my league. Yeah. And they were therefore indifferent to me, and therefore I would chase them relentlessly, and I got really good at it. Yeah. Because of that. And so in a weird way, this can actually be very good for you to be chasing girls who are indifferent to you, because you get good at chasing girls. You get good at the practice of it, right? But the fact of the matter is, chasing girls who are indifferent to you is psychologically damaging to a guy. Very damaging. And I can see it in myself, and I can see it in other men as well. To talk about other men, okay? These guys who chase indifferent women, they chase an indifferent woman, and they might marry that woman who's sort of like indifferent to them, and they're miserable, because they're constantly on a treadmill trying to please her, trying to get her, okay? And that, there's no resolution to it. There's no resolution to this search, and ultimately what winds up happening is that a guy winds up in a relationship in which he's very, very unsatisfied, and never calm, never at peace. And that's the problem. And it's something that you have to realize. You have to understand that if you constantly chase women who are indifferent to you, not because you're a bad guy or a low status guy, no, 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 because they just simply don't respond to you. You have qualities that just don't appeal to her, yeah? And that's why she's indifferent. And if you constantly chase her and perhaps get her, you're going to wind up with a woman who is just wrong for you. Wrong for you, and it's not just that she's going to make you miserable. It's not that she's going to actively try to screw up your life. It's not that it's a malicious person. No, it's somebody who's just not right for you. You have to guard against this. Yeah, this happens all the time. I mean, you see these marriages that are woefully unhappy, right? Because the guy wound up chasing a girl who had certain qualities. Maybe she was very attractive or very smart or this, that, the other. And she's a great person, okay? Again, I'm insisting, it's not that they are bad people, these women who are indifferent to you. It's just that she just doesn't respond to you. But at the same time, you know, a guy who chases such an indifferent girl and manages to snag her, you know, he's a resourceful guy. He's got something going for him. Going something that was strong enough and compelling enough that this indifferent girl wound up with him. But she wasn't really crazy for him. She wasn't crazy for him because she just doesn't ring his bells just because they don't fit, okay? And this happens all the time, and so you have to guard against it. You have to make sure if you're chasing girls who are indifferent to you and blowing off the ones who actually want you, who are attracted to you and make the effort to be with you, you got to figure out what's going on. You got to figure out what's going on in your heart. Yeah, because this is a you problem, not a her problem. You are chasing somebody because she's indifferent because of things that you lack in your heart. Yeah? Your mommy issues that I'm talking about, okay? And you want to call it something else, Oedipus, this, that, the other, doesn't matter what you call it. Ultimately, it's the same thing. you want somebody who is aloof. You want somebody who just doesn't really want you. That's what's going on. And you chase this person and you blow off good women, women who would make you exceedingly happy. Yeah, you blow them off chasing this aloof little angel. Yeah? And she's gorgeous, she's pretty, she's aloof, and that just makes you itch in a way that you cannot stop scratching, and you keep on chasing her. But you're not going to find anything. You're not going to find any kind of satisfaction, even when you get her.
Mm-hmm. You know, even at 51, I still find myself falling for this trap of just being incredibly attracted to women who are indifferent to me. Yeah. And again, you know, I have a lot of qualities going for me. And these are qualities that lots of women would be just delighted to have in a man, I mean, right? And yet I just sort of like blow them off. Blow off the women who actually want me, and I just have eyes only for these girls who are aloof. Yeah. And it's tragic and stupid. And you know, it's funny because, like I say, I'm 51 and I still fall for this trap, even though I know better. I've known better for a while, not as long as I would like to have. I mean, honestly, I think I figured this out when I was in my very late 30s, early 40s, something like that. I mean, think about it. I spent close to 40 years, or let me rephrase. I started chasing girls when I was, what, 13, 14, right? So between 14 and the age of 40, 26 years, a quarter of a century, chasing the wrong woman. Relentlessly chasing the wrong women. Yeah, relentlessly chasing them. And the worst, the thing that just drives me nuts is that I look back on the women that really wanted me to be with me and just to have a future with me and all that, and I blew them off consistently, and they were such better fits than the girlfriends that I had. Yeah, and that's the tragedy. I look back and I'm like, God damn, what was I thinking? You find yourself chasing girls that just don't give a shit about you. And blowing off these girls who just, you know, bring you chicken soup when you have a cold, right? And the girls who adore you and that you ignore, they're perfectly good-looking, perfectly delightful women, but you just blow them off. And you chase these aloof girls who are like mirages. Well, you got to wake up. You got to wake up and realize what's going on. It's you. You are at fault. You are the guy who's screwing up. Okay? Because you are chasing a mirage. She will not give you that thing that you think she will. That aloof, indifferent girl will not fulfill you the way you think she will. It's the girl who actually cares about you. The girl who brings you chicken soup when you're sick. The girl who likes the same movies that you do. The girl who laughs at the same jokes or the same situations. Yeah, the one who sends you the gif of like whatever that made her laugh and you look at it and makes you laugh, right? That's the girl you want in your life, not the aloof girl. Because again, the aloof girl, there's nothing wrong with her. She's perfectly fine. It's just that she doesn't fit with you. The connectors, they're not the same. Mm-hmm. And they'll make you unhappy. They'll make you woefully unhappy. It'll make you woefully unhappy because you are chasing your own psychosis, your own mental hang-up, your own whatever you want to call it. And maybe it has nothing to do with your mother. Maybe it's just a completely different source and you had a perfectly fine relationship with your mother. Who knows? It doesn't matter. The end result is the same. The aloof girl, the indifferent girl, you got to realize that she is aloof and indifferent for a reason. You and her do not fit. So don't force the fit.